Hey, what'd you bring in, Colonel?
Got you some venison.
And a cougar.
Heard about the bear, have you?
Big one, I heard.
Coffee, Mr. President?
Is that the bear?
Yes, this is the bear that attacked the horse camp at dawn. He knew that men would be asleep, or at their worst, at dawn. As you know, he injured one of the Indians quite severely. He killed several of the horses, too.
Did you yourself participate in stopping the bear, Mr. President?
Yes, I regret to say.
Why do you regret, Mr. President?
Because he's a fine creature. This is his valley. This valley belonged to the bear, and we're the intruders here. We're accustomed to wild animals taking flight at the sight of men with guns. The American grizzly fears nothing. Not man, not guns, not death.
Do you intend to have this bear as a rug in the White House, Mr. President?
Rug? No. No, I intend to have him stuffed and placed on exhibit at the Smithsonian Institute. The American grizzly bear is a symbol of the American character. Strength, intelligence, ferocity. A little blind and reckless at times. But courageous beyond all doubt. On one other trait that goes with all previous.
And that, Mr. President?
Loneliness. A bear lives out his life alone. Indomitable, unconquered, but always alone. He has no real allies, only enemies, but none of them are as great as he.
You feel this might be an American trait?
Certainly. The world will never love us. They respect us. They may even grow to fear us. They will never love us. But we have too much audacity. And we're a bit blind and reckless at times, too.
Are you perhaps referring to the Panama Canal and the situation in Morocco?
If you say so. The American grizzly embodies the spirit of America. He should be our symbol. Not that ridiculous eagle. He's no more than a dandified vulture. Dandified.